It has been a while. A while indeed. This is a camera walkthrough of the Pentax MX. Lighting in here is very limited, so you're gonna have to bear with me through that. I'll try my best. The Pentax MX was first released in 1976. It ran until 1985. On the front here, you have your self-timer, which moves down this way. As such, you advance the camera. This is already advanced. You press the button right there. The self-timer will run. It makes a god-awful gear spinning noise, as these all do. Wait for it. Okay, so as you could hear by those gears and by just about everything in this camera, it is completely mechanical, except for the light metering system, but we'll get to that. This is a mechanical camera, so all of the speeds that you see here, which it has a wide variety of speeds, there's bulb, 1 second, up to 1/1000th of a second. All of these speeds are manual, so you can shoot them with or without batteries. Your flash sync speed is going to be 60 here, as denoted with the orange and X there. And there's your hot shoe mount on the front. And on the side here, you have a flash sync port, which is protected by this fun little thing here. So you can just kind of shove that bad boy in there. You can have an external flash gun, which is great. Also on the top of the camera, you have this little switch on the shutter button. And when I move it over there, that orange L is revealed. When I move it back, it is hidden. So if I move this over that way, it is locked. So even though I have it advanced, it will not fire because it's locked. If I move it back over this way, it will fire. And that will also expose the little window, which will indicate whether or not it is advanced. You can see it right there, that little square sitting above the shutter speed selector. You have your advanced lever, which I feel like is a very ergonomic advanced lever, and that will kind of tuck into place right there. Your ASA wheel is sitting underneath the shutter speed selector, and you can switch that by pushing down on this little button there and simply turning the wheel. If you want to switch your shutter speeds, don't push down on that button and just move that as such. Over here, very simple. All you have is your film rewind lever. You pull that up, opens up the back. Here we have a cloth curtain, which is, and then you have a very standard M series take up spool here. So you just put the film lead in between that little white tubing and advance it and fire. Cool beans. On the bottom, you have your film rewind button, so you push that when you're done shooting. For the motor advance, you undo that, and these are the contacts for it. Screws into the bottom if you so choose to use that. Here you have your battery compartment. We'll take the two 1.5 LR44 batteries. Comes in this really neat little container. So you're gonna wanna put them in positive side up, both of them. Drop it in there, screw it up, good to go. Now, as I said previously, the only thing that is battery powered on this is the light meter. If you look through the viewfinder, which we're gonna try to do this, it's a little disc on the right side of the viewfinder, and that's going to show all of your shutter speeds. Now, there's a little bracket that the shutter speed that you're selected at will sit in the middle of that bracket. And you have five LEDs on the side of that disc. And so those LEDs are green in the middle, yellow, and then red on the outside. So that green is gonna be on exposure. Those yellows are going to be one stop on either side, over or under. And then the red is going to be two or more stops out of exposure. So basically, it's a really easy intuitive system of you're just trying to make the light green. Now, it's very helpful because of the disc, you can see which shutter speed you're shooting at, so you can look through the viewfinder and adjust your speed as necessary. And then also, what's very helpful and what's interesting about this camera in particular, the MX model, is that it has a small window right there. And this window comes from the prism. So as you're looking through on the top of the viewfinder, there's a little window that projects right down onto where you would have the lens. So obviously with these, you line up the red dots, move this over here. And as you can see, that window lines up with whatever aperture you have selected. So let's see if we can show that. Probably not. We can try. It's not gonna, you can see the little window up there, but if you're looking through, it will point down on this aperture. So if you're looking through and your shutter speed is what you wanted to shoot at, so you're shooting like action photography stuff, whatever, you're shooting a moving object, you want to be shooting at 1/1000th, right? 1/4 is not going to cut it, so you need to look through and adjust to 4, 5, 6. You can keep looking through the viewfinder and move it and make sure it lines up with whatever aperture you need to be shooting at. That's a really neat feature, and that was one of the things that really sets this camera apart in the way that it's more of a, it was designed to be more of a professional flagship model for the Pentax brand, replacing the larger KX and making it a smaller compact version that still has the same functionality but in a much smaller and contained package. Also, there is a way for you to access the focus screen by simply lifting up on this little lever down in there. That will pop out. I don't recommend you do that just because it's sometimes gonna be tricky to put it back together, but if you get gunk behind there, it's easy to just loosen that up and get in there with a little air rocket and get the gunk out. So I think that's very important as well. And I think that just about does it for this camera. Yeah, I would say that's it. So basically, that is the Pentax MX, and you don't even need batteries to use it. I think that's a great feature. They're definitely the more expensive of all of like the Pentax M series cameras. So if you can find one for a decent price, I would definitely say go for it. It's definitely worth it. But just be careful because not all of them are in great shape. So you want to be careful for that as well. Because as is with any of these very small mechanical cameras, a couple bumps on the body could mean that some of the mechanisms are broken. So be careful with that, but I definitely recommend these. These are great little cameras. Thank you for tuning in to this quick little walkthrough video. Hope you learned something. If you have any questions, make sure to put a comment down below. I will get back to you as soon as I can. Shoot me an email if you need any help with repairs. Like, comment, subscribe to the channel, all that stuff. We're going on a year of me trying to produce stuff for this channel. So keeping that energy flowing, keeping that content going. Yeah, appreciate you watching and catch you on the next one.